Good morning, dog breeder friends. I'm Dr. E. Let's continue this series of videos on canine herpes virus. So, you know, let's focus today on the clinical signs that are caused by this virus. And you know what? It's kind of interesting because I'm pretty sure there are many clinical signs people are not aware of. So in this video, we're gonna dig in this specific topic. Watch to find out what I mean.
When it comes to clinical signs of herpes, we can have these myriads of signs. Some of you mentioned cough. It is important to keep in mind that herpes virus can infect the respiratory tract. In fact, herpes are viruses of what we call the cold mucosa, but we'll come back to that because this is a very important data to keep in mind. And it is an agent of the kennel cough syndrome. So when you come back from a dog show with a dog suffering from kennel cough, it's very rare that it is herpes. But keep in mind that it could eventually be. You guys are breeding dogs, and as you know, you are predisposed to see things normal people will never see. Even as veterinarians, many things you guys see, we won't. Some of my colleagues will never see in their practice. So kennel cough can be one of the clinical signs you see in case of herpes virus infection. Not very common, again, but that's possible. I like the comment some of you give on ophthalmology disorders. We can indeed have ocular issues. There are several, in fact, publications that were written on the effect of herpes virus on the eye of the dogs, and it can eventually cause ulcers, etc. But again, it's pretty rare. It's not that common. But these are clinical signs we can find. What we, in terms of canine reproduction, the most common clinical signs that are described in the adults are essentially inflammation of the genital tract. So here you have a picture of what we call a balanospothitis, an inflammation of the penis in a male dog. So you can see here areas of inflammation on the penis of this male, and this could eventually be caused by herpes virus. However, I'm showing you this picture. This is not an herpes infection, this is a bacterial infection of the penis. Those inflammation of the penis have been described in experimental studies, but they are very, very rare. I remember my former boss and mentor, Alain Fonbon, telling me he has never seen a balanospothitis induced by herpes, and same thing, I've never seen one, but it is described in the literature, so potentially you could see inflammation of the genital tract. And you could see vaginitis, inflammation of the vagina. But what is more common, look at the vulva of this bitch here. Everything looks normal, except here. This little pimple here, which, well, if the picture was of better quality, you would see it's a white pimple. So a white pimple on the cold mucosa, like the genital mucosa, the vulvas, or on the lips of the dog, could eventually be related to herpes virus. But the fact is that many, many of you were right as well. Many said no symptoms. In fact, those clinical signs, we often see them when the bitch is infected for the first time, when the male is infected for the first time. Again, because of the latency phenomenon, then remember, the virus is going to hide someplace in the brain of those dogs. And very often, when this virus reactivates, we don't see any clinical signs at all. We don't see anything. Those individuals are totally asymptomatic. And because of that, you can have an individual that looks totally healthy shedding herpes virus inside your kennel. That's totally possible, again, because many, many individuals, from a clinical standpoint, are totally asymptomatic.